when you're in a pinch and you don't have any tools around, a wrench, vice grips, and you need to get a bolt out or a lag screw, you can use a bolt wrench. If you have this around, you can use a nut with a hex cap screw. This is a short version. This is a long version with a shoulder, and you have two nuts on here, okay? And you just adjust the nuts to the size of the head, the flats, and then, and if you can, if you have square nuts, you're better off with square nuts. I'm doing it here with hex nuts, and you will see you can start to turn this off. Now these hex nuts are chamfered. When they have a chamfer on them, it makes it a little harder, but you can see here that you can make this work when in the pinch. Okay, you can do that on a hex lag screw. Now you can do it on the head here. It's the same type of head. Now this is a, I would say, a 5/16 head across the flats. You can also do it with a nut on the opposite side. So let's see if I can get this off after I adjust this here. And it makes it harder when you have this scenario with the bolt even sticking up a little bit. There it goes. Starts to turn. And it'll come off that way. These are grade 8 bolts. Depending on the size of your bolt you're taking off and how much torque is on those bolts is going to make a difference. Obviously, the longer the bolt, the more leverage you're going to have in breaking the bolt off or breaking its locking position. You can also do it with a small one like this too in a tight space. You can just use your fastener or a hex cap screw. Install the hex cap screw all the way in to the insert. And take the insert and start and get it started. Grab your ratchet and drive it in. Okay, we're almost there, not there 100% yet. Okay, that's pretty good. Okay, I've driven in the insert with a hex cap screw. I'm gonna now back this off and take the screw out. And you can see there that the insert is in place. So I just put the zip tie in place. And if you don't have a snips, you can just use your pliers. Take a pliers and just turn it clockwise or counterclockwise. And now it's finished off. And if you want to remove it and reuse it again, just turn it over to the back and just snip a little further away from the clasp. And you pop it back out, and then you can reuse the zip tie again for smaller things. When using imperial fasteners, do not use a metric socket to drive in an imperial. If you do that, you'll see here that there is play. This is the 13 millimeter socket. And a half inch or 5/16-18 hex cap screw. And if I use that and I start talking on this screw, I will be stripping out the head. If you use the correct size, an imperial half inch with a half inch socket driver, there is very little play in there. Versus if you use a 13 millimeter, there is substantially more play. Thus, you're going to strip the head. So I have here a magnet that I crazy glued to the top of the extension of my ratchet set. And what that'll do for me, as you can see right here, this is glued on with crazy glue, and I'll slip my socket over, and now I can put my bolt in there and it doesn't fall out. So when you're working on restoring a car, working on an engine, you can't get down into the car to find that bolt that you dropped, or maybe you're gonna use one of these things to try and find it. This prevents you from losing the bolt, and it works very effectively. It also works with stainless. Stainless is partially magnetic, and as you can see there, it's not as strong as working with grade 8, grade 5, an alloy product, but it does hold it in there. It will not work with aluminum. It'll just fall out. But with a grade 8 product or a grade 5 or a grade 2, this is the perfect fix. So you don't have to go looking underneath the car, moving the car, getting pissed off, trying to find your bolts. When you're using an extension cord and you're using a tool, it could be a saw, could be a hand saw, anything with power, a lot of people just take it and they plug it in. That usually ends up that you have to pull on the plug or the wire, the extension cord wire is hooked on something, or something it's coming around a corner and you pull on the cord and it just pulls apart. What I like to do is I take the two plugs, put them together like that, wrap it around, bring it through a loop, pull a knot, and then take the two and put them together. So when you pull on it, your cords never come apart, no matter where you are. You could be up on a roof, on the side of a house, you could be working in your shop, you pull on the extension cord, you have no worries. To prevent damage to your threads, if you were to take a threaded stud like I'm working on here right now for a customer, and to put it into the device and tighten it up, you could damage the threads, press them, and then when you go to put a nut on there, it's gonna gel basically on you. So to prevent that from happening, you can take a towel or a rag and just hang it over the top, put it in the vise like this, tighten it up, just put enough pressure on there, do your work, take it out, and there's no damage to the threads. So I have here some newspaper. I have a 9-volt battery. I have some fine steel wool. This is 4-0s. The finer, the better for using it for this purpose. Could be your old stuff too, if you're a woodworker. You could use your old steel wool for this. Never store a 9-volt battery along with steel wool in the same location if you're putting it in your backpack. Put them in two different areas to isolate them from each other. And I'm gonna show you how to quickly just start a fire. No need to take two pieces of wood and rub them together and all those great things they do. This is the quickest way to get a fire going. Okay, I'm gonna just take the battery and I'm going to connect the steel wool with the battery. You're gonna see here it's starting to amber. okay? And I'm just going to put some paper on it. There we go. So obviously you would need a little more feeding for the to get the fire further going, but this is just a demonstration to show you how a battery and a piece of steel wool will start a fire for you.